Hi, welcome back to my channel. Harriet here. I'm going to be giving a few tips on how to identify red flags in a relationship. That is before marriage. How do you get to know these red flags so that you decide maybe to call it quits, you decide to end the relationship before it's too late or before it gets into marriage, which is a lifelong term commitment. One of the red flags is if you visit this person unannounced, once in a while, of course, not often, because people need their space. If you visit them unannounced and they are furious about you unannounced coming, they are not comfortable with you just appearing at their place without calling, what would they be hiding? What's making them uncomfortable? And also, if maybe you visit and you find a lady's clothes, or men's clothes at their place, and maybe they claim they're for their brother or sister, and when you call or find out from this brother or sister, they claim the clothes belong to, and they say they have no idea about that. The clothes are not theirs. Whose clothes could those be? Sometimes we ignore such red flags, and yet they're giving us an indication of who this person is. So before we get into a serious marriage commitment, when there are any of these red flags, of course, it is you to make the choice. It is your life and all. These are my opinions. So these red flags should be able to help you to make a decision to get into a committed relationship or get into marriage as well to move to the next level. Another red flag can be if the marriage topic pops up in your conversations when you're still dating, like I said, and the person always changes the subject. They are not comfortable discussing a marriage topic. Maybe they are not ready for marriage. Please be patient with them, because everyone has a season in their life. It could not be a season for marriage in their life. Be patient with them. Let them, give them space, you know. Also, if they're always talking negatively about marriage, this is a big deal. There are people who are so negative about things in life. If this person talks negatively about marriage, every time they never talk well, speak well, positively about marriage, could be a red flag. They're not interested. They don't support marriage. So if you go ahead and marry this person, you could be in a marriage alone. And that marriage is a partnership. The two of you have to make it work. So do not enter into a marriage with someone who is not ready, someone who's negative about marriage. Let them first sort their attitude. Let them first sort their thoughts and opinions toward marriage. If a person doesn't respect you and your boundaries, for example, if you've said or discussed that there's no having sex before marriage, this person is pressurizing you, male or female, it's both ways. If this person wants you to sleep with them to prove their love for you or your love for them, do not go in for this. Do not defile your body. Rather, honor God with your body. For ladies, it's high time we actually got to take this seriously. A man sleeping with you, having sex with you before marriage, before committing in a marriage relationship, doesn't mean they are going to love you more. Doesn't mean they are going to commit. Doesn't mean they will, you know, commit in this marriage relationship once you get to another level of marriage. It doesn't mean they will marry. It doesn't mean they will commit. Let's take this seriously and respect ourselves and value ourselves and value our bodies. A man should love you enough to respect, honor, and appreciate your parents for raising you, for taking care of you. It shouldn't just start with sleeping with you for them to marry you. Let them start with marrying you. Then sex will be enjoyed in marriage. Another red flag is if this person hits you, if they raise their hand on you and hit you, if they hurt you, they are most likely to do it even in marriage. This is a red flag. When you're still dating someone and they're able to raise their hand and hurt you, if they hit you, it's a red flag. Take it seriously. Do not think that someone will change when they get married. People do not change, and you cannot change a human being. You cannot change a fellow human being. It's only God who does the changing. Another red flag is if they cheat on you and you are sure they have cheated on you, they are most likely to do it again. It might be their habit. They're most likely to do it again in marriage. So do not take it lightly when someone cheats on you. Do not. It's a red flag. Do not possibly take it lightly that they will change, or even if they apologize 100,000 times. Same thing with hitting. They will apologize, but please, it's your life. You do not want to have a miserable life in marriage. Marriage is a lifelong relationship. do not make the mistake of deceiving yourself that this person will change, they will be better. No, it can't happen. And also, if this person is not committed in the relationship, for example, you plan for dates, for meetups, for outings, and this person always has reasons, excuses for not making it. If they do it often, like really, if they do it often, in your heart of hearts, you will clearly know and feel that they are not committed. They are not ready for either relationship or marriage. So before you get into the marriage relationship, which is highest level of commitment in a relationship, please iron out such stuff. If a person is not committed, they are most likely to continue like that. You are most likely to be in a marriage with them, but you will be in alone. They won't be committed as well. The other red flag is if someone compares you with another person, it is so wrong for someone to compare with someone else because we are different. If they compare your cooking, your dress code, your talking, maybe the kind of job you're doing, the kind of money you're earning, kind of car you're driving, if they compare with someone else, it's not right. They should accept you and love you the way you are. It's no good to compare because everyone is unique, everyone is special, everyone is beautiful, everyone is, you know, we are just different. We are unique, we are special. And it's a good thing because if all people were the same, then I think life would be boring. I just hope one of these tips or all of them will help you to make the right choice, will help you to make the right decision about your relationship, current or future relationship. If you have any other red flags that you know about, please put them in the comment section below. If you've not subscribed, please do subscribe. Thank you and see you in the next vlog.